So welcome back. We are discussing Indian Contract Act 1872. This is the second video and we are going to discuss contract and agreement. In the first video, we discussed there are four pillars for Indian Contract Act 1872. The first one is the key concepts and definition. Second one is enforceable by law. Third one is discharge of contract. And the fourth one is remedies for a breach of contract. Okay, so in this particular video, we are going to discuss key terms, contract and agreement. Okay, let's look in the case of contract, right? Three important points which we need to know. One is, what is contract, essential element of contract and type of contract. Okay, so Section 2H of Indian Contract Act defines, contract is an agreement. It is an agreement which is enforceable by law. If we closely look into this definition, there are two elements for contract. What are the two elements? One is, there should be an agreement. It is an agreement. And the second one, this agreement should be enforceable by law. Okay. So to call anything as a contract, there should be an agreement and then it should be enforceable by law. Take a small example to understand what is the contract. Okay. Mr. A says he wants to sell his car for rupees 2,50,000. He tells to Mr. B. And Mr. B agrees that and he is ready to give 2,50,000. And take a ownership of a car, right? This is all about contract. Contract is something where one person sells it, other person agrees and pay a consideration. This is what we discussed in the introduction slide. Okay, contract. So there is an agreement between A and B and they are dealing with some goods, which is a legal object. So it is enforceable by law. So contract includes both. One is agreement, the agreement between A and B, and the second one, whatever the dealings they are doing, it should be illegal. Selling a car is a legal business, right? So it is enforceable by law. This is important. Okay, contract is an agreement which is enforceable by law, and two elements are, one is there should be an agreement and then enforceable by law. Let us look into what is agreement and what is enforceable by law in detail. Agreement. Before we get into an agreement, let's see key essentials for agreement. Essentials for agreement, and then we will come to the definition. Okay. Essential for agreement. The first one is, there should be two parties. Okay. There should be minimum two parties. And the second one, there should be an offer from one person. And then there should be an acceptance by other person. As we discussed, A wants to sell his car for 2,50,000 to B, and B gives his acceptance. Right? A is giving an offer. Offer means one person is signifying or he is telling that he wants to do certain action, and other person is giving his assent, his acceptance for the same. Then only the agreement will be formed. So two important elements of offer are, agreement are, there should be offer and then there should be acceptance. So before going into a definition of agreement, let us see what is offer and what is acceptance or a promise. Okay. Offer, according to Section 2A of Indian Contract Act, offer means when one person will signify to another person his willingness to do or not to do something with a view to obtaining the assent from the such other party. Right? Here we discussed A is willing to sell his car, and why is telling this information to B? He is telling this information to B to get his assent. So to call it as an offer, there should be three things. One is, one person has to express his willingness, and it should be informed to other person, and then other person has to give is acceptance. These are the three, okay, these are the three important points with respect to offer. Offer is a one person where when one person will signify to another person his willingness to do or not to do something with a view to obtain the assent of such person. The important is get an assent of such person to such act or assistance. He is said to be make a proposal or an offer. The other word for offer is proposal. Proposal or offer is same. Okay. Then we will discuss offer and acceptance in detail in the next video. But here, just you know the basic. Offer is the willingness of one person to perform certain activity or not to perform certain activity, and he will tell it to other person. Okay. And then acceptance. What is acceptance? When the person makes an offer, the other person gives his assent, signifies his assent thereto. So A is making an offer here and B is giving an assent, acceptance, or it is called as a promise. So in Indian Contract Act, there is no definition for acceptance. There is a definition only for a promise. So what is promise? When the person to whom the proposal is made. In the given example, the proposal is made to whom? Proposal is made to B. And signifies his assent thereto. B is giving his assent. Okay, I am going to buy your car. The proposal is said to be accepted. The offer, whatever A made or a proposal, is said to be accepted. When this proposal is accepted, it becomes promise. Okay, when proposal is accepted, it will be called as a promise or acceptance. Clear, guys? One person make an offer and this is offer, and the second person gives a acceptance. This acceptance is called as promise. Okay? Then question comes, what is agreement? So we discussed what is offer, what is acceptance, correct? So section 2E of the Indian Contract Act 1872 defines agreement as every promise and every set of promises forming the consideration for each other is an agreement. Okay. Every promise and every set of promises forming the consideration for each other is an agreement. Okay. So when offer A makes of selling his car and B accepts it, there are promise, right? A promises that he will transfer the ownership of car. The first promise is A transfers ownership. Okay. And the second one is B promises he will pay 2,50,000. Out of that, 1,50,000 may be cash and another 1 lakh by bank. Okay, so these all are the promises, right? Every promise or one promise or a set of promise, okay, for any consideration, whatever we have discussed. So every promise or a set of promise forming the consideration for each other, for both the parties, is called as an agreement. So agreement is a set of promises, very simple, okay? It is a set of promises. Okay, A agrees to do this, B agrees to do this, and both the parties will sign here. So that's it. Clear, guys? So agreement is a set of promise which is forming the part of consideration for the each of these parties. Okay, clear? Agreement, offer, acceptance. So if we see the previous definition, we discussed about agreement. Agreement includes both offer and acceptance. Okay. Now we will discuss enforceable by law. What is enforceable by law? Okay. So one is very simple. We talked about agreement, the first step. And the second step is all the agreement must be enforceable by law. What does it mean? Enforceable by law means if any problem happens in the agreement, both in either of the parties can go to a court. Okay, so to go to a court, The agreement should be between two competent parties. What does it mean? Party should not be a minor. Who are a competent parties? The party should not be a minor. Person should be of sound mind. Okay? He should be of a sound mind. He should not be a lunatic, idiot, or person of unsound mind. Okay? So, he should not be a minor. He should not be a lunatic, idiot, or unsound mind. He should be a sound mind. And then, the second one is, he should be more than 18 years or 21 years as the case. Okay, is a competent party. Then free consent. What does it free consent means? Free consent means when A makes an offer to B and B accepts it. Here is an offer and here is an acceptance. They voluntarily should make all these things. A should offer it voluntarily to B and B should accept it voluntarily. A should not threaten, if you are not accepting my offer, I'm going to kill you. Right? So that threatening should not be there. There should be a free consent from B also. Otherwise, B should not tell to A that if you are not selling your car, I'm going to kill you. That is also wrong. So there should not be no threatening, coercion, or there should not be a misrepresentation of facts. Misrepresentation of fact means his car is completely outdated, sorry, his car is completely damaged, there was an accident for that, then he has to disclose all these facts before selling it to other party. Okay, so any information pertaining to the object should be informed to the other party, otherwise the contract will be considered as a not a free consent. So there are multiple points within free consent. So if the free consent means both the parties should agree the facts without any threatenings or a coercion or any misrepresentation or a fraud. They should voluntarily review and give a acceptance. And then the legal object. The subject matter of the contract should be a legal. Okay, whatever person wants to do or not to do, right? Offer means a person willingness to do or not to do something, right? All these things should be a legal action, legal items. Okay, it should not be a for offame, okay, offame sale or a murder contract, right? All these things are illegal contracts, illegal objects. So to call it as a legal enforceable, the object of the contract should be a legal. Okay, it is for some goods, it is for some services, it is for some goods or services, okay, either both. So whatever, the objective of that should be a legal, it is not to kill person or it is something illegal. Okay, all agreements are, I hope you are clear, we discussed one is agreement and the second one is legal enforceable. Now, before we move to a next topic, types of contract, it is important to know as this sentence. Okay, this is a very very important, listen carefully. All agreements are not contract, but all contracts are agreement. Can you say why it is? It is very simple. When we say contract, to become a contract, there must be one is agreement and the second one is enforceable by law. Okay, so that's why to have a contract, to set it as a contract, there must be an agreement. So that's why all contracts are agreement. Clear? So contract cannot become in isolation. To make a contract, agreement is a must. So that's why all contracts are agreement. But all agreements are not enforceable. All agreements are not contract. The second point, the thing is, all agreements are not contract. How it is? If there are agreement, two agreements I will give you. One is for selling a car A to B, car sale. Okay, this is agreement, right? And also the objective of the sale is car, so it is legal. So there is an agreement and there is a legal objective. Then only it becomes contract. This is contract. Agreed? There is another contract where A says to B, contract is to kill C. Correct? There is also an agreement. A is telling to B, kill C, and B accepted. There is an offer, there is an acceptance. So this is agreement. But is this legal? Here it was yes, but here it is no. This is not a legal. So then this agreement is not a contract. Correct? So all contracts are agreement. But all agreements, here we have two agreement, both of these, one is contract, but this is not a contract. Agreed? So this is very important. All agreements are not contract, but all contracts are agreement. So if you go through this definition, which is given in section 10, you will be very clear on this particular concept. All agreements are contracts if they are made by the free consent of the parties competent to contract for a lawful consideration. So it is not only agreement is essential, there should be other factors also essential to call it as a contract. One is there should be free consent, and then there should be a competent parties, and then there should be consideration, and then there should be a lawful object. Okay, then only it is called as contract, otherwise it lies only as an agreement. I hope you guys are clear why all agreements are not contract, but all contracts are agreement. You have to quote section 10 and then write the example, two examples. Moving to our next topic, which is types of contract. Types of contract, there are we can classify types of contract by validity, by formation, by performance. Under validity, we have a valid contract, voidable contract, and then we have illegal contract, unforeseeable contract. And under formation, we have express contract, implied contract, quasi contract, and e-contracts. And by performance, we have four: executed contract, executory contract, unilateral contract, and bilateral contract. Let us look into each of these types of contract in detail now. Valid contract. So valid, void, and voidable. Illegal and unforeseeable are very simple. I will explain. Illegal we will discuss along with a void contract, and unforeseeable we will discuss last. Okay, there are three important contracts under by validity: valid contracts, void contracts, voidable contracts. Okay, let's see. Valid contracts, we will go one by one in detail here. Valid contracts. What is valid contracts? If contract, we said contract is equal to, every time I am saying, agreement and enforceable by law. Right? Enforceable by law. Right? These two should be there. If when all these are there, all the characteristics of agreement, all the characteristics of enforceable by law are there, then only it will be called as valid contracts. So let's see what are the essentials of valid contracts. One is two parties, as we discussed, there should be one person who makes offer and the other party who accepts it. Okay, no need to give more explanation for that. And the legal relation. Legal relation is most important point of a valid contract. What does it mean? Okay, take a simple example, Mr. X and Mr. Y. Both are friends. Okay, Mr. X invites Mr. Y for a tea. Okay, and Mr. Y gives his acceptance. Okay, for a tea at 5 o'clock in Taj Hotel. Okay, and this is an offer by Mr. X, where Mr. X invited Mr. Y for a tea at Taj Hotel at 5 p.m. tomorrow. And tomorrow, when Mr. Y get ready and he goes to a Taj Hotel at 5 p.m. and he will not find Mr. X. Can Mr. Y sue to Mr. X that you have not honored your offer? I have accepted and I came here at 5 p.m. No, this is a social contract, right? There is no consideration here. There is no what we call like object or something. This is a social contract. So there should be a legal relation actually. All social contracts will not be considered as valid contracts under Indian Contract Act of 1872. At the same time, there was a case which you need to remember here is Balfour versus Balfour. Okay, this is a social contract when husband and wife, or the husband leaves to a UK and then he agrees that he will make certain payments to his wife for a maintenance, but because of some uncertain reasons he was not able to make a payment. So again, this is a typically a social contract, not a subject matter of Indian Contract Act 1872. So case law for this is Balfour versus Balfour. Okay, again, the another essential valid essentials of valid contract is free consent. Free consent, we already discussed many times. Free consent means both the parties voluntarily accept this. Okay, voluntarily give their consent. There should not be any coercion. Okay, there should not be any undue influence. If your teacher says you do it, then you will do it, right? It is an undue influence. And then fraud, there should not be any fraud. Any misrepresentation, there should not be any misrepresentation of facts. And then mistake. We talk about all these points in detail, okay, when we talk about free consent. Okay, free consent means both the parties have to give acceptance without any threat, coercion, or with some undue influence, or with some fraud or misrepresentation or a mistake. Okay, so there should be a free consent. And then lawful object. What is lawful object? Lawful object is something. Okay, the lawful object means whatever the objective or a purpose, subject matter of a contract must be lawful. What does it mean? Any item which is forbidden by law. Okay, forbidden by law. So dealing in liquor is banned in Gujarat. So any contracts with respect to liquor in Gujarat is void. It is not a valid contract. Okay, or if it is defeating the provisions of any law. Defeating the provisions of any law. Okay, there is a law within if there is a law we should not deal with of him, then dealing with of him is a crime. So it is a illegal. So it is not a valid contract. Any contract related to of him is illegal. And then the contract for causing injury to any person or building or properties, right? Any kind of these kind of contracts related to this will be called as unlawful and it is not a valid contract. And some immoral contracts. Okay, immoral contracts are a huge list for that. We will discuss that when we will talk about lawful object in an enforceable bylaw section. Okay, so we discussed four important points. There should be two parties, legal relation, there should be free consent, and it should be a lawful object. And now the lawful consideration. If A says to B, I'll give my car without saying any amount, and simply it transfers it free. Is this a contract? No, this is not a contract. It is a contract when A transfers to B for 2,50,000, when B pays for it. Car is going on this side to B and B is transferring amount. So this is a consideration. So there should be a lawful consideration for any contract. Then only it is called as a valid contract. Competent parties. We discussed this. Person of a age 18 or 21 years. And then he should be of a sound mind. Right? These are the two important aspects of competent parties. To call it as a contract, the contract should be between persons of more than 21 years age and then sound mind. And then there should be valid offer. One person has to make an offer, and then there should be unconditional acceptance. When A gives an offer of 2,50,000 car, B should accept his yes. He cannot say that I will pay 2 lakh. Then it becomes a reverse offer that we will discuss later. So whatever offer is made, there should be an unconditional acceptance from other party. Okay. And the last one is possibility of performance. Possibility of performance means at the time of entering into a contract, whatever the subject matter should be able to complete, like parties should be able to complete it. If A is not having a car at all, okay, and if he try to enter an agreement with B that whenever he get a car and then he will transfer it, so this is not okay. It is, there should be a possibility of performance at the time of the contract. Say for example, there is a chance that India declares the other country as an enemy country. Okay, India declares one other country as an enemy country. Okay, and if there is a contract with the enemy country, this contract cannot be executable. It is not possible to perform at all. So any contracts with enemy countries are void. That's why it is impossible to perform. Correct? So at the time of entering into a contract, the act should be possible to perform. If it is not possible, then the contract is not a valid contract. So all these are 9 points we discussed, are essentials of valid contract. There should be two parties, legal relationship should be there, free consent, lawful object, lawful consideration, competent parties, valid offers, unconditional acceptance, and possibility of performance. Okay, take a pause for a minute and then we will see what is void contract. Okay, void contracts. We will see these points. Void contracts, right? Void contract means not leak. These contracts are void contracts. Void contracts means which are not legally enforceable. These are the contracts which are not legally enforceable. What does it mean? In case of any problem, the party should not be able to go to a court for a settlement. They cannot go to a court for a settlement. Okay. Certain contracts are void at the time of a beginning of the contract itself. Beginning of the contract. Okay. At the beginning of the contract itself is a void. For example, entering contract with a minor. It is a void. Straight away. There is no point of discussion. It is void ab initio. ab initio means it is void at the beginning of the contract itself. Or if you are dealing with some illegal objects, this is also void at the beginning of the contract itself. Agreed? So any contract which is forbidden by law, or if it is entered with a minor, all these things are void at the time of the initial phase of the contract itself, at the beginning. At the same time, there are some contracts which are void after entering, like at the time of entry, it is after entering into contract. What does it mean? At the time of entry, it is a valid contract, but after entering into a contract, it turns into a void. What is those things? This is a situation where we call it as agreement to do impossibilities. Okay, sometimes. Okay, say for example, on 10th, there are two parties, A and B. A in one country, I don't take a country names here to give a conflict, and B is another country. Okay, another country. Okay, so A enter a contract with B to buy 100 kg of raw materials, and B agrees to supply this, and A agreed to pay $20,000. Okay, A is in one country and B is in another country. So A wanted to buy 100 kgs of raw materials, B agreed to supply for this, and A agreed to pay $20,000 for this. Assume that this happened on a 10th May. Okay, the execution date of the contract is 25th May. On 15th May, if war broke out, if war started between A and B, then this particular contract becomes impossible to perform. Right? So, at the time of entering a contract, it was valid. Because of some circumstances, because of a war, now it has become impossible to perform. So this is a void contract after entering into a contract. Okay, there are two cases of a void contract. One is void at the beginning of the contract itself, like minor or illegal object and other things. And then after entering into a contract, because of the changing a law or because of changing into a relationships of a countries, that will become void. Clear guys? The void contract can be at the beginning or even after entering into a contract. Another important aspect, right? We saw here illegal. Okay. Illegal contracts are also void from the beginning itself. If you enter into a contract for some illegal objects, then the contract is void. So illegal contract is a subset of a void. Void contract, there are many. Okay, under this, there is a illegal contract. All illegal contracts are void. Okay, but all void contracts are not illegal. Remember guys, all void contracts are not illegal. See, entering contract, it was a valid year, after that it become void. But it is not a illegal also. So all illegal contracts are void. If you enter into a contract for afim selling, or if you enter into a contract for killing someone, all those are void contracts. But there are certain void contracts which are not illegal. They enter into a contract, but after that it may not be able to perform. So that's why all void contracts are not illegal, but all illegal contracts are void. Okay, now see, what all are the contracts which are not enforceable by law? If there is an unlawful object, we discuss umpteen number of time what is unlawful object, and if there is a no consideration. So every contract must have some consideration, and if there is no lawful consideration, then it is a void. Restraint to marriage. Any act tries to restrict the marriage of the other party, then that will be called as a void contract. Restraint to trade. What does it mean? Restraint to trade means if A and B are there, B is a gold seller or a jewelry shop owner, A comes and tells to B that you should stop doing the your jewelry business, I will pay you X amount. Okay, so this is restraint to trade. He is restricting him to do trade. Every person can do whatever the trade they want to do it. So these kind of restrictions are not allowed. These kinds of restrictions are void contracts. Okay, restraint to legal proceedings. Any contract entered to restrain the legal proceedings will be treated as void. And unmeaning agreements. If there is no clauses defined properly, there is no objectives are defined properly, under those circumstances it will be called as unmeaning agreement and then it is void. Okay, the next one is wagering agreement. What is wagering agreement? It is simple. Anything is based on uncertain event. Any contract is based on uncertain event where both the parties have equal chance to win. So A and B agrees into a contract. If rains tomorrow, A pay 50,000 to B. Otherwise, B pays 50,000 to A. Okay, this is uncertain event. There is an equal chance that tomorrow rain may come or may not come. There is an equal chance for A to win and for B also to win. So 50,000. If rain comes, then B has to pay 50,000 to A. Otherwise, if rain is not coming, then A has to pay 50,000 to B. So this kind of wagering agreement, which is based on uncertain events, will not be considered as a contract, and all these are void contracts. And agreement to do impossibilities. If you have an agreement to perform certain activities which are impossible to do it. Okay, when a person don't have any daughters, but he get into agreement with the other party that I will marry my daughter to your son. Okay, when it is impossible to perform, if the object is not exist at all, then where is the question of performing the contract, right? If anything is there, or selling a liquor in Gujarat, which is a banned. So in those cases, it is impossible to perform any agreements where it is impossible to perform, then that will be called as void. Okay, these are the cases of a void contracts. Void contract means a contracts which are not legally enforceable. Void contracts also includes illegal contracts. All illegal contracts are void, but all void contracts are not illegal. Okay, few examples of void contracts are a contract for unlawful object, a contract without consideration, a contract for restraint to marriage, a contract for restraint to trade, a contract for restraint to legal proceedings, and unmeaning agreements and wagering agreements which are depending on certain uncertain events, and agreement to do certain impossibilities. All these things will be considered as a void contract. So void contracts, certain contracts are void ab initio, means these all are contracts which are void from the beginning itself. Certain contracts are void after entering into a contract. This is all we discussed with respect to a void contract. Take a pause, remember whatever we discuss, then we will go to voidable contract. Okay, voidable contract. What is voidable contract? Voidable contract, okay, it is all depends on a one person's decision now. Okay, we have A and B. Okay, A and B. A wanted to sell his car. For how much? 2,50,000. Okay, in this case there was an accident to that car, but this information was not shared with B. Clear? A and B agreed into a contract where A is ready to sell his car for 2,50,000 to B, and B asks him, is there any accident? A says no to it, but there was an accident to car. This is a case of a misrepresentation, right? There was an accident, but A didn't inform that to B. Okay. So after that, they enter into a contract, and on the transfer day, B comes to know that there was an accident. So at the time of execution, B comes to know there was an accident. Now you tell me, is this contract is a valid or a void? So this contract is called as a voidable contract. Voidable contract, because it all depends on B now. If B says, okay, I ignore this accident, it was a minor, I will go ahead and then I will buy it. If B decides to buy the car, even if it is accident, then this is called as valid contract. If B decides he will not buy the car, then it will become void contract. It all depends on one person. Okay, so A has done a mistake because of a misrepresentation. So the B is now decision maker whether to convert this contract into valid or to make this as a void or a cancelled contract. Clear, guys? Voidable contract is something which is called as contract which can be valid or void based on the decision of one party. At the time of entering into a contract, it will be valid only. They do everything whatever is possible as a valid. But after entering into a contract, some information came out, and based on that, it turns into a voidable, and it depends on one person's decision. What are the circumstances? One, we said it is misrepresentation. In what are the other circumstances when the contract becomes voidable? In case of a coercion. Coercion means threatening. If A threatens to B, you accept it, then it is a coercion. Undue influence. Assume A is a employer and B is a employee. Okay, in a same company. A is employer and in the same company B works as an employee. A says, I have old vehicle of rupee car which is for 2,50,000, you buy it. Otherwise, it is a problem for you. Right? He is an employee, so he can terminate it, whatever. He will not express it. But there is an influence because he is an employer and he is an employee. So he influences it. It is an undue influence. So then it is at the discretion of a B, this contract can be converted into void or valid. Same way fraud. If any acceptance was taken by a fraud. Fraud and misrepresentation, two different cases. Fraud is an intentional one. Okay, and misrepresentation is a unintentional. Sorry, mistake is a unintentional. Okay, fraud is intentional. To cheat someone, you are doing certain action, and the mistake is a unintentional. Okay, all these things contract, if any contract entered with these conditions or these situations, it will be called as a voidable contract. Whoever the party who suffered because of this, it will be on a decision of that party to consider that contract is a valid or void. Clear, guys? So we discuss three important points: valid, void, voidable. And illegal is also part of a void contract. This one we discussed. And then the last left over is unforeseeable. Unenforceable. Unenforceable contract is, it is same as all valid contract, it will be there. But because of some technical reasons, okay, the contract should be submitted on 21st, you submitted on 22nd, whatever. Because of some technical reasons, if contract is not unenforceable, then it is called as unenforceable contract, not an important one. So the important is valid, void with illegal, and then voidable. Clear, guys? Take a pause and then we discuss in brief by formation and by performance. Just a recap, whatever we discussed about valid contracts, void contracts and voidable contracts. Okay, so now we are here where we are going to discuss in brief about express, implied, quasi, e-commerce. These are the contracts which are classified based on the formation. Simple explanations, I don't go into a detail of all these things. Express contracts are something where every aspect of the contracts was clearly discussed, either it is spoken or written, but every contract details were expressed and discussed in detail. What is that? You want to sell something item, what is the consideration, how much, how to pay, every aspect of the contract is discussed in detail, then it is called as express contract. The express contract might be in might be a spoken contract or a written contract. Okay, if what is implied contract? Implied contract is a situation where the action of the other party will be like considered as an offer or acceptance. When the other party's action makes that it is a contract, it is an offer or it is an acceptance, then those things are called as a implied contracts. An implied contracts is one for which the proposal or acceptance is made otherwise than in words. It is not written or spoken. It is just by a action. Okay, the implied contracts are inferred from the circumstances of the case. Okay, it is a action. It is, there is no words or there is no spoken, there is no written document or there is no spoken agreement between those two parties. Okay, so example is very simple. If you board a bus, okay, if you board a bus, you are accepting, right? You are accepting that fares, whatever conductor says, you are accepting that that is a fare for you, right? It's an implied contract. When you are boarding a bus, it is implied that you are going to accept the fare whatever conductor is going to say. That is an implied contract. Now, coming to a quasi contract. What is the third contract here is the quasi contract. The important one, what is quasi contract? We will discuss this in detail later on with a complete case of a quasi contract. Any ideas what is quasi contracts? Okay, these are the contracts. One second. Okay, these are the contracts. These are not a contracts, first thing, right? These are not a contract, these are called as a quasi contract, but it looks similar to contract, and this will be performed or because of obligations imposed by law. Okay, these are the contracts which are created by a law. This will be performed because it is an obligation imposed by law. Okay, there is no intention of an offer or a seller by acceptance here because of the legal things, right? Legal things, these contracts will be entered. The basic reason behind the quasi contract is the principle of unjust enrichment. Okay, unjust enrichment means nobody should become rich at others cost. Okay, say for example, where all these quasi contracts come into picture. Okay, A lost his purse, okay, and B found it. Okay, so this is something, there is no contract here, right? B has to go and return it back to A. There is no contract. But law says it is B's responsibility to go and find up me and return it, otherwise go and give it in a police station, right? B cannot become a rich at the cost of A's loss, right? So this is a case of a quasi contract. There is no contract at all here, but B cannot keep the purse with him. If anything happened, then he will be held responsible. So it is his responsibility to go back and give it to, find out the owner and give it to them. Otherwise, at least go to a police station and hand it over. This is the one case of a quasi contract. There was no offer, there was no acceptance, but because of a law, B is bound to perform certain activities. This is called as a quasi contract. Okay, and the other example also we will take. You order on Amazon Samsung mobile phone. Okay, once you get a box, you will get Samsung mobile phone plus a tablet, both. Then it is your responsibility to return it back to the Amazon, whatever you received extra. Okay, so it is this person, whoever purchased this from Amazon, he should not get be benefited because of the mistake of Amazon. So he ordered only for a mobile phone, so it is his responsibility to return it back. So this contract, whatever he is returning it back to Amazon, is a quasi contract. So there is no agreement, there is no acceptance, there is no offer, but still it is called as a contract, which is called as a quasi contract. So a quasi contract is one which is created by law. In the quasi contract, there is no intention on either side to make a contract. In a quasi contract, right and obligation arise not by an agreement but by operation of a law. Hope you guys are clear about what is quasi contract and examples with respect to a quasi contract. Moving to the last classification, by performance. By performance, we have executed, executory, unilateral and bilateral. So, okay, executed, executory, unilateral and bilateral. So executed contract means it is all valid and executed, signed by both the parties. Okay, whatever contract is executed and then both of them have performed their obligations. So there is contract and then both the parties have performed their actions. So same example, I'm not confusing A and B, car sale. So A is transferred all the car ownership and B transferred 2,50,000. So after that it is done, right? So this is an executed contract. Executory contract is which is either unperformed, it is not only performed, or it is a partially performed. The contract is in progress. Okay, it is executory contract is something, contract is in progress. So it may be completed afterwards. It is a contract is in progress. So A transferred his car to B here and the B will transfer 2,50,000 after 10 days. So it is in either only unperformed or something remains. So partly it is pending. One party has executed, the other party is not executed, something. Fine. Okay. Now unilateral contract. Unilateral contract is a situation where only one party has to satisfy his obligation at the time of a formation of it, and the other person will do the activity at the end of it or something. Like for example, when you board a auto, okay, a auto driver will take you to your destination. So yes, this is the one where it is an action of an auto driver. It is a unilateral, right? he has to do his duty first. And then once you reach the destination, it is a duty of a rider to give the fare. Right? Whatever the agreed fare. So, the contract at the time of the initiation, one person has to complete the obligation and the other person will act after that. In case of bilateral contract, both the parties will act together. For example, buying a building. So, one person transfers the building, the other person pays the price. So, it is an exchange of promise. It is an exchange of promise. It is a normal contract. Okay, in a unilateral contract, at the time of the contract, only one person has to satisfy his obligation. But in the case of bilateral, it is a mutual promise and they both have to agree on it. So, with this, we covered all the types of contract. Contract based on validity, by formation, by performance. We discussed valid, void and illegal, voidable, illegal we already discussed, and unforeseeable, express, implied, quasi, e-contracts, executed, executory, unilateral and bilateral. I think I missed e-contracts. E-contracts is nothing but a modern race contract where you, when you when you order something on Amazon, you sign terms and conditions, right? All these all happen on a e-commerce platform. So, it is a e-contracts. Anything happens on the e-commerce platform is called as e-contracts. That's it, guys. I tried to cover key concept of contract and agreement and also types of contract. Hope you guys will go through it once again, and then in the next video we will discuss offer and acceptance.